Hello, my name is Elena Dubova. I am an embryologist at Alice Fertility Clinic. I've been an embryologist for 10 years. I've graduated from the Karazin National University of Kharkiv in the Department of Genetics, after which I studied at the Otto St. Petersburg Research Institute, where I performed karyotyping for couples. My embryological journey started in the Nadia Clinic in Kyiv. There, I learned the whole cycle of embryos work, from getting them via puncture, fixation and defrosting, to transferring the embryos to the womb cavity. And I studied all the spermiogram techniques. For the last 5 years, I have worked at the Family Planning Institute's Medical Center in Kyiv, where I introduced new embryology methods to improve the clinic results. Embryology is a science that is constantly evolving, with new high-end equipment and new techniques. So the embryologist has to keep up with it. That's why I'm constantly evolving, participating in scientific conferences. I trained in Simferopol and Lviv clinics. I completed courses on theoretical embryology improvement in Kyiv. I finished a course on blastomy and trophoblast biopsy at the Adonis clinic. Also, I am a member of ESHRE. As an embryologist in the Alice Fertility Clinic, I really want to introduce innovative approaches into the embryological protocols so that all our patients can get a long-awaited pregnancy, and Alice Fertility Clinic would become one of the most advanced, high-class and proficient clinics worldwide. The Alice Fertility Clinic Reproductive Technology Division is a team of specialists. They are reproductive scientists, andrologists, embryologists, obstetrician-gynecologists and ultrasound specialists. The whole team aims to achieve a positive result. The reproductive therapist deals with female infertility factors and the andrologist deals with the male ones. The embryologist can help choose the correct fertilization method, offer pre-implantation genetic diagnostics, and consult on previous cultivation protocols. We approach each patient individually. The embryologist's main task is to get the long-awaited pregnancy and give a feeling of joy of parenthood to the couple. The embryologist works with sex cells and embryos. During a follicle puncture, a reproductive physician receives a follicular fluid and transfers it to an embryological laboratory. Then, in a laminar flow cabinet under a sterile microscope, the embryologist takes oocytes. After that, we purify oocytes from cumulus cells and assess their maturity. Fertilization requires oocytes that have undergone all cycles of aortic division. We call them M2 oocytes. We also wash the semen from the seminal fluid. 3 hours after the puncture, we do an ICSI. We choose the best spermatozoon by its morphology and activity. We use the injection pipette to mobilize the spermatozoon, and by holding pipette, we fix the oocyte and inject the spermatozoon into it. These eggs are then transferred to a special cultural cup with a cultural environment and placed in an incubator with a constant temperature. After fertilization, in 16 to 18 hours, we evaluate its effectiveness. We observe zygotes and estimate their morphology and quantity. We also assess the amount and quality of blastomeres every day. A fetus develops from intracellular mast cells, and a placenta develops from the trophoblast cells. We also estimate them by morphology and quantity. One or two embryos of the best quality are selected for transfer. The rest of them are vitrified and stored in cryoboxes. Yes, Alice Fertility Clinic provides an embryologist consult. During this, the embryologist will tell you what will happen to your sex cells, recommend the suitable method of fertilization, tell you about the pre-implantation genetic diagnostics, and will consult on previous embryo cultivation protocols. All of this is to help you find the right treatment tactics to get a positive result. In 5 to 6 days, we get blastocyst. We estimate it by the quantity and quality of cells. Then we choose to transport one or two embryos, and the rest are vitrified. No, it's not dangerous if an embryo is ahead of development. It is dangerous when it stops developing. During IVF, we can perform pre-implantation genetic diagnostics. It's committed to determining the normality of the embryo and its sex. The sex can be chosen for medical reasons if the couple has sex-related genetic diseases. Ukraine is one of the few countries in the world with ideal conditions for clinical embryology development. In addition to high-end specialists and high-tech equipment, we have a reasonably loyal legal system. Here, surrogacy services, egg, embryo, and sperm donations are permitted. Unlike in other countries, molecular genetic research on embryos is allowed. All such procedures are notably affordable in our country than in the EU countries and America. Therefore, thanks to such favorable circumstances, Ukraine is one of the world's leaders in reproductive medicine. Several factors need to be considered when predicting IVF effectiveness. The first is the woman's age. The older the woman, the lower the quality of the eggs. This, of course, is individual and depends on her health and lifestyle. Second is a particular cause of infertility. The third is the duration of attempts to become pregnant naturally. The fourth is whether or not there have been previous IVF attempts and their efficiency. The fifth is the quality of the embryos we've received. In the IVF program, during medically induced ovulation, we get 12 or more eggs. On the fifth day, we receive several embryos. One or two are transferred, and the rest are vitrified and stored in cryo-duos. After the first attempt, if we have a negative HCG result, we can use frozen embryos, and we proceed to do this until we get a positive result. If we've used all the embryos and haven't had a positive result yet, then the next IVF cycle comes. Unfortunately, many myths about IVF have led many couples to abandon this safe and effective treatment. The first myth is that children after IVF lag in their development. Numerous pediatric observations of babies after in vitro fertilization have long disapproved this. And it has long been proven that children after IVF are not fundamentally different or slow, not mentally nor physically, from their peers. The second myth is that IVF always ends with multiple pregnancies. It is because previously two or more embryos were transferred into the uterus. It was done to increase the likelihood of pregnancy. Now, only one embryo is transferred. The third myth is that many couples presume that they cannot choose the sex of a future baby. However, we can choose sex not only on a medical condition basis, but also at the parents' request. Yes, indeed, there is such a project as a pronuclear transfer or children from three parents. It's based on a unique technology that allows a healthy baby to be born to a woman with mitochondrial damage in her eggs. Under this procedure, the genetic material is removed from the donor egg and replaced by the oocyte pronucleus and the semen of the future parents. So you have an embryo with a donor cytoplasm with healthy mitochondria and a biological parent's complete genetic material. More than 7 babies have been born in the world thanks to this technology. 6 of them were born in Ukraine. When is coffee time? Of course, it's a joke. Basically, the reproductive scientist is very busy with received eggs, their quantity and quality, how the embryos develop, and how many of them we will transfer. Because the embryologist is the first person involved and knows all the information about embryos and eggs. Embryologists often have complicated cases that they have to deal with. One of such cases was when we got 16 eggs from the patient, and the man didn't have any spermatozoon. Eventually, He underwent TESA, testicular sperm aspiration, and the ICSI was conducted. It was overwhelming happiness when on the fifth day we received 10 beautiful blastocysts, of which two were transferred to the womb cavity, and we got the long-awaited pregnancy. The second complicated case was a couple who had only 3 eggs and the man had azoospermia. So on the fifth day we got 1 embryo and we made pre-implantation genetic diagnostics, and this embryo was a healthy boy. Eventually, it was transferred to a woman's uterus, and now this pregnancy is developing. The third case was peculiar. A woman wanted twins, but according to the reproductive physician's testimonies, 1 embryo was scheduled for the transfer. Finally, a month later, we discovered 2 heartbeats on the ultrasound. Those were monozygotic diamniotic twins.